Last night in the county jail, a woman wouldn't even come and post my bail. They locked me up and threw me in the door. Well, I might have been here a couple times before. Uh-huh. Well, I shot this man down in Tennessee, and he's trying to steal my girl away from me. They took away my only gun. All I was trying to do is have me some fun. Uh-huh.
Dirt Poor on WEFT Sessions, and I'd like to start out by saying, well, I guess I already started out, but that sounded fantastic.
Well, thank you very much.
Is that going to be on the new EP?
We have a new EP. It should have been out maybe a week ago, but, you know, life happens, you know, and we're working out. We got about one more day in the studio to master all the tracks and mix everything, and yeah, that'll be one of the 5 songs on the new EP.
Ordinarily, I would ask Mike to make sure I can play it back next week, but if you're going to have a studio copy, might rather I play that.
Yeah, if you want to play the live version, that's all right with us, but we'll have a studio version here in like week and a half, and we can always just bring it in and send it to you guys, and that way you can have the studio version of it.
Well, yeah, if I have the EP next week, I would like to play that. What was it called?
That was called County Jail. It was written a couple months ago. It's kind of it's a story song, you know, totally made up about a guy who, you know, gets married and...
Oh, it's not all true?
Oh, not all true. You know?
I don't like it anymore.
Finds his woman in bed with someone else, you know, and then it goes from there. Ends up
oh, dear.
Jail, so.
I'm sure it ends up well.
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, it can only end up well if the song's called County Jail, so... But yeah, this next one we'll be playing, it's called Tennessee. It'll also be it will be one of the 5 on the EP. Now, this one was written a while ago, but we kind of brushed it off and then came back to it, kind of gave it a revamped, refurbished, you know, feel to it, ended up putting a little country-ish intro to it, and so that way we're just kind of re-going back to it and we'll put it on the EP, so yeah.
Well, I'm excited. I just ripped to my computer a CD by a band that was on the show 9 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
They had an EP that was about to come out, and I think the second song was called Tennessee.
All right.
It still hasn't come out.
Well, we will make sure. We will make sure that this Tennessee does come out within the next week.
It's a race. You beat them and you win.
Hey, if we can get it out in a week and they still have, you know, they've done it 9 years, hopefully we can make up, you know, that little time period. So, but
I am looking forward.
All right. Well, thank you. Yeah, but this is called Tennessee. Slowing down up here and I don't know why. Time to walk across the old county line. To the south is where I think I'll go. I lost touch up here and I just don't know. Well, I just don't know. See. right, thank you, listeners. Our next one is, this one's called Otis. This is a brand new one, but it won't be on the EP. It'll be released, hopefully, on our next album, which I wish I could tell you when would be coming out.
Yeah.
we hear it.
So I realized, even though we did this before the show, on the air we haven't actually done a roll call so that you guys all get credit for doing the show for future generations of listeners.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, let's do it.
I'm not actually here.
Yeah, all right, so I'm Emmett. I'm rhythm guitar singer, all that jazz. You can try to be the front man. We got Matt Porter over here on bass. The fun fact is, last year we didn't have a bassist. We actually just got him about a month ago. His first show with us.
Did you find him on eBay?
Yeah, I got him for a
He came with the bass.
Great price, you know, like I was the lowest bidder, you know, it was a perfect deal.
When I got a guitar, it did not come with a guitarist.
But anyway, no, yeah, he started playing with us about a month ago, and then his first show was with us 2 weeks ago at Memphis on Main when we headlined there and played with Finer Feelings and Penny Horses. So yeah, Matt Porter on the bass. We got Louie Kingston, who's apparently not present, but he's on the drums.
I just want to say what a trooper she is for being here without him.
Yeah, out of all of our friends, you know, Louie, our one audience member tonight is Louie's girlfriend, Reagan. So let's all give Reagan a little clap. We appreciate it.
Now, since he's not here, does she drum?
She's basically on the drums tonight. So whatever you hear, that's all Reagan.
I think my favorite verb in Spanish is to drum.
There we go. But then we have Nate Finn on lead guitar over to my right, and those guys have been with me since the start of it, by the way, too. So, but yep, that's the whole band right there. So
excellent. Now, I think we touched on this when you were here before, but before Matt joined, how did the other three of you start playing together?
We've been about a year ago was like the official start of the band. Started writing original stuff. Had our first show in January. But we've known each other, us three have known each other since 12 or 13 years old. And in high school, we had this, it was a pretty cool class. We had this, it was a jazz rock combo class. So it was basically all drum sets, guitars and bass guitars and singers. It was basically rock band. I don't think I ever played one jazz song while I was in that class. No. But we already all knew each other, but that's how we started playing music with each other. We were in a cover band in high school with a couple other of our friends and stuff. And then we graduated, kind of went our own separate ways for about a year, year and a half, and then we all came back together and were like, hey, you want to give us a try? And went from there.
At my high school, jazz band was what they put on your schedule when you'd taken all the classes they offered and they had a blank.
Oh, no, yeah, we had those two. Our senior year, we had a music theory class, and it was, I think, other than maybe one other person, it was just me, Nate, and Louie, and our high school band teacher the entire year.
That sounds pretty good, actually.
We used to make waffles every morning.
There is one thing you didn't mention that I'd like to touch on. Mm-hmm. Normally we have this big, well, I say we have this big, I think it's built up in my head. Mm-hmm. It's like, is the band going to be from Champaign or Urbana? And I think you guys might be broadening the circle.
Yeah, we grew up, well, yeah, so we went to high school at Unity High School in Tolono.
Bingo.
So Louie's from Tolono, Nate's from Sydney, Porter's also from Sydney, he grew up with us as well. And then I'm from Pasotum, so we're from all the small towns south of Champaign-Urbana.
You know how people have this annoying tendency? Oh, you're from New York. Do you know David?
Oh, yeah.
But
yeah.
When you said Pasotum, my first thought is, do you know Leonard? And I thought, Pasotum's small enough.
Oh, no,
you actually might.
It's like 400 people, but no, I do not know Leonard, you know? Hey, I might know his face, though. You show me a picture.
I am worried Leonard might be like 110 if he were still around.
Okay,
he was pretty up in years when I met him.
Okay, well, I'm 21, so, you know, we might be able to bridge that gap, but I'm not sure.
Well, Leonard knew Pasotum like the...
The whole time, the whole time. Basically, since his existence, you know, if he's over 100.
He could tell you anything based on Pasotum.
Anything that came from the town.
He could tell you who was going to be president based on if they had 63 or 65% support in Pasotum. So, anyway,
like
you probably want to get to a couple more songs.
We're
so
good, yeah. But yeah, we got another... The next one up next is a... Well, it's a little embarrassing, but we don't have a name for it even yet. It's brand new. We call it the new heavy one. But this won't also be on the EP. This will be on after the EP. The EP's kind of bridging the gap between now and our album that's coming later on.
So, I am in favor of between albums releases.
Yeah, see, there we go. Yep. So yeah, this one's called the new heavy one. Yep. We'll be right back.
sunrise is burning up the sky and a few satellites are the only things left. I was the one who killed all my time. This cold wind has been stealing my breath. Didn't know why I react now in my cigarettes. I losing their taste. My bones and nerves are never intact. I sent all my wishes back into space. Woo! Son, I'm proud of you no matter what you ever do. Let the happiness I found or let the past drag you down to. We're all just children in our own backyards playing games in small living rooms. I wonder how I got so far. I ran away too fast and too soon.
That was a brand new heavy one. we're gonna play an old one next. This is our first single that we released. It's called "Buy You a Home." It's one of the I think the first five tracks we ever wrote. So.
Thank you. sin. I'm living on an edge of the whim. I'm tired of these three walls closing in. Stab me with a broken bottle of gin.
So we are just past the half, or I guess right at the half, since we started maybe a minute late, and a minute late is on time.
Yeah, that is very on time. Yeah, it was better than on time. Yeah.
We were on time. We just weren't cutting anybody off.
Yeah, exactly. You know.
So.
Yeah.
Which, I'm. One after is fantastic.
Oh yeah. But yeah, that was our very first single that we actually. And let out and put on Bandcamp, you know, and YouTube and all that jazz and stuff. And we're probably gonna end up re-recording that as well. Just the first time we ever recorded, you know, when you're a band, especially called the Dirt Poor, and we have no money, you know, you're sitting in the studio and you're like, yeah, you know, I don't really like that take, but you know, oh, we only got 30 minutes left, so
she'll do.
So yeah, we're kind of. Just after, you know, I mean, it takes a little while for the band to find their sound and stuff like that. So we've basically been using this year to kind of figure out where we want to go with everything and how we want to sound and define it.
Why do you think more game shows don't give away free studio time
that
as
would
a prize?
Be, oh, my gosh. You know how quickly I would try to hop on Wheel of Fortune or something
like that?
Yeah,
oh. Pat, I'll go with the free studio time.
Yeah, exactly.
They just look at you.
I'd like to solve the puzzle, please.
Now, reason I was talking about time in a minute after is that I was going to lead off with the station ID. And I did a really good job of going ahead and doing that. So before any more grass grows beneath our sneakers, boots, whatever, this is WEFT 90.1 FM Champaign. You're listening to WEFT Sessions with, obviously, the Dirt Poor. They just said so. And would you like to give out your booking?
Yeah. So we got our Facebook. If you just type in the.dirt.poor.music. It'll get you to there, or if you just, you know, look us up, we'll be one of the first bands popping up. So we have our Facebook. We also have our Bandcamp. That's what we'll be releasing our EP on as well. To download it, we'll just to donate whatever you want to pay for the digital download.
So I can go ahead and find it there even before I get a hard copy.
Yeah. That'll be. We'll make a couple. We'll start to get a couple out to send to venues and everything. But it'll be the digital download will be available first, and then we'll start burning CDs and making sleeves for them and stuff like that. Because it'll also be available physically, as well. But yeah, digital download would be the first way to go. And the way to do that is just to go to our Bandcamp page, and you can find that link on our Facebook. And then we'll also probably release, if not the whole EP, but like this, the first single from the EP on our. We have a YouTube channel too, and we'll put a video up that way. If you just want to go online and listen to it, you got that as well.
Have you ever considered writing a song called Signal?
You know, I probably need to. That way I can just say that, because apparently I can't remember the word for single.
Signal?
Well, yeah. if your single were called Signal, then you'd have
it work out perfectly, you know? Yeah, so I might as well just do that. But yeah, so we have our, and then we have a dirtpoor at Gmail, so that's kind of our main booking option. That's what we send it out, and we'll have our electronic press kit all ready to go, and you know, and all that jazz. But we have our Facebook, Bandcamp, and our YouTube channel, and those are our three main sites.
Now, maybe I missed it because you covered so much ground there, mm-hmm. but since you have an EP coming out, mm-hmm. Are there hard dates you have booked that you want to advertise?
Nope. You can hear from our drummer.
I didn't miss it then.
No, right now we're kind of in talks with a couple other shows and stuff. We you know, through email and stuff. We have a couple venues in Chicago and Indy waiting for, you know, another college town, just waiting to hear EPK and stuff.
How far from Tolono and Sydney and Pisotum have you played?
Champaign.
Okay.
Champaign,
You're looking at it.
I feel like haven't we played
Champaign
and Urbana?
Urbana.
We played outside.
You know what you should do? You should play Champaign and Urbana, Ohio, just
there we go.
Just
yeah.
for irony.
Oh, there we go. Just so we can. But no, we played all over downtown, Memphis on Main, Mike and Molly's, of course, Cowboy Monkey. We're talking maybe to try to get into a show at the Accord. It's just, you know, when it's a we have a great music scene here, but when it's only, you know, college sized town, you can't. It's not like we can just play every month. You know, you want to space it out and stuff. Well, we played Iron Post and all that.
There's also the weird fact that a lot of people think the music scene is because of campus, and it seems like it's almost irrespective of campus.
Yeah, we played Urbana, but that was the Iron Post. I don't think we've ever had a campus show.
I should clarify. We get musicians from campus.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just most of the audiences don't seem to be.
Yeah, we found outside of our specific fan base, you know, friends we grew up with and people we've known through other people, like the big majority of our crowd that we don't actually know is the downtown locals that walk through. Like at our Memphis show with Penny Horses and Finer Feelings like 2 weeks ago, you know, half of the crowd was Penny Horses fans, our fans and stuff, but then the other half were just the really supportive locals that we have in this town coming through. Just, you know, they don't care about paying that $5 just to come check out a band and, you know, support local music. So we really appreciate that. Yeah,
it's not even five; it's $1.66 if you split it three ways.
There you go. Yeah, see, that's perfect. But yeah, we really love the downtown scene. That's where we've gotten the most support and stuff. And we've all met so many great other musicians and local bands who are super supportive of each other band. Like if we have a show, you know, that's why we called up Finer Feelings and Penny Horses. We played with them before, and we've done that with Hot Hand Luke and the Sound and stuff, and they've done it, reciprocated it our way as well. So that's what I really love to find out and all that jazz.
It's good to hear you're having a good experience.
Yeah.
I'd love to hear more about it, but I also know you have some mm-hmm. new songs still to get to. So this next one going to be?
This one is another one that will be on the EP. It's a brand new one. It's called Tear Up the Silver Screen.
Did you say what the title of the EP is?
I did not.
Is it a secret?
We don't have one.
No, it's a secret. I'm going to say it's a secret, but, you know, we might not have one, but it might be a secret.
The We Don't Have One EP featuring the lead single,
yeah.
Signal.
Signal, yeah, exactly. But yeah, this next one's called Tear Up the Silver Screen.
Woke up and got out of bed for the first time today. Gonna leave my best friend's apartment, pack Kansas City away. Head on past the Rockies, tear up the silver screen. Met a young Hollywood starlet, get me in the movies. We'll be right back.
But yeah, that one was Tear the Silver Screen, and it will be one of the 5 new ones on the upcoming EP. This next one we have coming up is an oldie, and it was actually from our very first demo. This Love is Poison.
Yeah, I remember this song.
I know how this goes.
Well, that's good.
I can play this.
Running a little bit early in the booth tonight, which is nice. Got the later portion of the show already ready, and that meant I was able to get to listener feedback sooner, and the first comment out of the box was that you guys sound great. So,
well, thank you, whoever that listener is. We appreciate that.
I'm always glad to know. I mean, I don't need my opinion validated, but it's always nice to have a second, you know?
Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely. Oh, I thought you were going for the mic, Nate. I thought you had something to say. Nothing to say. But yeah, we appreciate everyone who's tuned in tonight, online, all of our family and friends, and then all of the random people out there that we don't know who you are, but we appreciate you guys tuning in, checking us out, if it's your first time or second time or whatever.
The weird thing, we had some discussions this week about our terrestrial radio listeners.
Yeah, yeah.
But when I'm doing WEFT sessions, I mostly hear from the ones that are listening long distance.
Yeah, okay.
And it's amazing how many states have been represented over the years.
No, I know last time we were on there, I knew it was my cousin, obviously, unless someone in Florida outside of my cousin knew about us. But we had someone from Florida tune in and make a comment. I'm guessing it's my cousin. I never validated that. It could have been just some random guy in Tallahassee.
I've already heard from somebody in Florida that is not your...
Not my cousin?
Well, it would be a very small world if this person is indeed your cousin.
Okay, I mean, you know what? I appreciate all my cousins, Florida, if you're listening, but I kind of hope it's not, you know, because it gives you a little feeling, you know, that there's someone in Florida that knows who I am from online and listens to our music.
Did you say Tallahassee?
Yeah, but that's not where my family's from, though.
Okay.
No. So if you are from Tallahassee, thank you for tuning in.
Do you mind, I don't really like the word shout out, but do you mind saying where your family down there is?
Oh, no, yeah. Shout out to Vero Beach and Gainesville, and then Fort Myers, because I have friends down there, too. So if you're not from those three cities and you tune in, thank you.
Now, did your cousin ever live here?
No.
Okay, because we had somebody pretty prominent in the scene moved to Tallahassee recently.
Yeah, but no, yeah, I do not know anyone in Tallahassee, so hopefully, you know, you never know.
We could fix that, but it's probably not at the top of your list.
Exactly.
So what do you have for us next?
We got two more. One of them's pretty long, but, give our last little shout-outs and stuff.
If you do the long one, could we recap after that?
Yeah, we can do that. That'd be perfect, because the last two, they'll be on they're both going to be on this upcoming EP. This one that we're going to play just now, Kid from Illinois, it's a brand new one. We just started playing it at shows maybe two shows ago.
There is a problem. WEFT does not like new or obscure music. We only want stuff that people are into.
Okay, well, then never mind. We're gonna play a cover then, I guess. But no, yeah, this next one's Kid from Illinois. It's just maybe 2 months old. It'll be on the new EP. And then the one after that, it's an older one that we've kind of refurbished, revamped. Same with kind of Tennessee, where we kind of went away from it after we wrote it. And then we were like, it ain't too bad, you know, and kind of hashed it out and got back to it. So yeah, this next one is Kid from Illinois, and it'll be on the upcoming EP.
I'll be back after this song.
Cool. Take it away.
Slowly breathe.